We welcome you live to SAP Center in downtown San Jose. It's a Saturday night on ice, and the defending champions are in town as the Sharks get set to take on the Tampa Bay Lightning. There's Victor Hedman, two seasons ago, the most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and a Norris Trophy winner in 2018 is the top defenseman in the NHL. First of two meetings this season between the Sharks and the Lightning, and they'll play again before the All-Star break next week.
Because it's hard to coach a good team.
McDonough gets across the Sharks' line, then he ran into Šimek, but they score!
I think it's always a good play to go to the body, but that back check has got to be stronger, does it not? But all that wouldn't really have mattered in that situation. Unfortunate bounce there.
Yeah, I didn't mind this play by Vlasic. He held as long as he could to prevent the pass across.
Here's Foote playing it ahead. Cirelli couldn't pick it up for Tampa, and the Sharks defense handles it as Ryan Merkley works it back through center ice, but he gave it up to Braden Point. Point, far side, Kucherov, and a glove save by Reimer. Stamkos, that's behind Killorn, picks it up and sends it to Hedman up top. Foote with the one-timer, blocked by Gregor, and it stung him. Now Foote again, into the middle, Killorn. Now Stamkos, and he scores! A screen in front by Joseph, who was there with Vlasic. Reimer couldn't see it. And the Lightning go ahead 2-0 on the 20th of the year for the captain.
You've got so many different angles of attack. Very hard for the Sharks to pick up. But the key to me is what you've been talking about, inside position for the screen.
Yeah, and just Killorn, they've seen a lot of this where they pop that third forward out high right there. And that's where Hurdle has to drive way out there to the top of the circle. Briand
at 7:45. So the Lightning score two in a little over 4 minutes. And they open things up here 2-0 in the opening period. Kucherov gets away from Barabanov. Hedman a blast. That's blocked in front by Ferraro. And now the Sharks trying to get something going in the Tampa end of the ice. Now from the right point side, it's handled by the defenseman Schuster, who gets it down behind the net. Ryan Merkley works it to the other side for the Sharks. Up the middle, it's Andrew Cogliano. Drops for Bonino, and he shot it high. Jonathan Dahlin, one goal in his last 28. He had that great start when he got 8 goals. There's a chance in front for Hurdle, and Brian Elliott came up with the save. That's a big stop for Tampa here in a first period where they've been dominant. Now Stamkos against Burns. Gets by him, and Reimer with the pad out, and they score on the rebound. Punched home by Matthew Joseph, 3-0.
Good acceleration by Stamkos here, Brett, but look at how Joseph put the brakes on at the high slot. And that way, he's in the right position to stay with the puck and keep going.
Yeah, Stamkos lowered the shoulder, had a little bit of step on Burns, and you're right, Joseph, when he hits the brakes there, is able to hit one, two chances at it and gets it by James Reimer. But that all started again. Good defensive breakout by Tampa.
Six Lightning players with 10 or more goals this season. The Sharks have just three of those. Hurdle, Meyer, and Couture, as Belmar will steer it back to the line. McDonough, the former first rounder of Montreal. There's a shot by Belmar, and on the rebound, it's Corey Perry, and this one's getting away early. It's 4-0.
Trying to find it. He actually turns his back to where the puck is. It goes into the zone, bounces. You look at where Jacob's trying to find it. Then he turns around. There's the shot. Everybody's trying to find it. Nobody's got the stick of Corey Perry. And if you're near the net in your own zone, Brett, if Corey Perry's there, you got to find that guy.
Yeah, well, you can see right there on that last replay, Drew, and this is what I could see from ice level.
So the goaltender change here in the first period, very unusual. And Aiden Hill, who suffered the loss in Seattle on Thursday night when the Sharks fell for the second time to the expansion Kraken. Murray back in the day, he was one. Chris Pronger for sure. Ed Belfour, after he became a Shark and then left in free agency. They all qualify as Hurdle's shot is blocked, but Merkley keeps it going. Back for Megna. They score!
Brett, exactly what you talked about. Chip away, needed something from somebody, they got it.
Yeah, 100%. What a little play from Barabanov. There's the shot, and then Timo Meyer, I think, gets a little piece of this. Nice little play into Megna from Merkley. Quick shot, that's the difference maker. And then right there, you can see Meyer just gets a piece of it.
Well said by John Cooper, one of, if not the best in the coaching business in hockey right now. There's a puck to the net right off the get-go by the Sharks. Gave Brian Elliott some trouble. See if the Sharks can get back in it here as Gregor fans. Now from the wing, Couture put it into the crowd at the front of the net. Wheels it back for Burns. Burns loads up, fires it. They crash the net, and they pull it off the goal line, or almost.
Hedman did.
Victor Hedman behind the goaltender, Elliott.
Winning the races and getting to the right spots. Again, that's really important if you're trying to fight your way back into a game.
Yeah, and Couture getting inside. Quick shot. Burns just gets his puck through. I like Nieto up there with this line. They ended that first period up there with Logie Couture.
Gregor getting it behind the D-man Hedman. Points there. He's moved off the puck by Nieto on the forecheck. Now Matt Nieto works to get it up top for Merkley, and he did seal the boards, but it pops free, and now Cirelli. Two on one with Kucherov. Kucherov waits. The trailer is point. He scores. 5-1 Tampa Bay.
What's the key on this play?
Yeah, the puck or the man, right? You got to get the puck 100%, but Kucherov just going to make you pay as now they're trying to reel on a two-on-two, or basically a two-on-one with this back checker late to point right there. He's just one-times it by Hill.
A 647 regular season win percentage in his career. That's the second highest ever behind only Scotty Bowman. That's pretty good company. And the Alberta-born John Cooper. A wraparound bid here by the Sharks. And the puck's in the net. They score! Brian Elliott protesting, but Timo Meier makes it count. And it's 5-2.
Past the goal line. I don't know how this will go, but as you said, Randy, the call on the ice is goal.
So now there's two aspects to this. It's being reviewed, number one, as to how it entered the net.
View, it was determined the puck was put into the net with a distinct kicking motion. We have no goal.
Let the Lightning have it again. Colton. And that's kept in at the line by Merkley. Nice play there. And now the Sharks go to work. A quick shot from the wing. That was Weatherby wide of the net. Now back it comes. Elliott trying to find it. And he's got it. Sharks creating havoc this second period in front of the Lightning net. But so far, Brian Elliott's been up to the task.
That would have been maybe a hand pass there, but a good job alert to get that. But I love this shot right here by VL. He covers, quick shot to the front, one guy Raska there.
As Brett talked about earlier, their middle grouping, their second six, their middle draft choices have all been outstanding.
Here's Braden Point with a break. Throws on the break, spinorama, and it's saved by Aiden Hill. What a move by Point, but what a stop by the Sharks goaltender.
The Tampa Bay Lightning, Al Murray, who's director of scouting, and Steve Eisman were going to watch Morgan Rielly play in the playoffs. But Al Murray said, watch this kid. I've been watching him. He was 16 years old at the time.
Now Barabanov. Here's Timo Meier. Circles the net. To his forehand, and it comes off the crossbar. Sharks hit three posts or crossbars Thursday in Seattle. Megna and Thiel, and that will go off a skate and through the crease to the near boards for Couture.
There's Weatherby, had that puck there just inside that blue line. He's got to navigate that down into the corner instead of in the middle of the ice. So these are little things he'll learn.
We've got a San Jose penalty, first of the game, against the Sharks.
This is Barabanov right here. Yeah, gets a stick in on Corey Perry.
Yeah.
And Corey, go ahead, Drew.
I was going to say, that stick gets parallel, gets on the body. That's the call now.
With the new baby at home, he might want to take a nap. Stamkos one-timer, goes wide. Now Hedman calmly back over to the magician. Kucherov to Point. Nice save by Hill. Stamkos in that stop, too. In the last three regular seasons in a row that he's played in. Stamkos. Back for Kucherov. Into Point. Saved by Hill. Reoccurring theme.
Yeah.
Kucherov again. They do not give the puck up much. And he gets it through. Hedman does. Might have been tipped by Killorn. And it's 6-1.
It's all things that make a power play really good, but it's also skilled players. And Brett, once again, inside position underneath everybody.
Yeah, and I love this shot from the middle of the ice from Hedman. And Killorn puts himself out front to, you know, just soft enough, just hard enough to get there.
Second point of the game for Alex Killorn. That's his 13th goal of the year. And the Lightning power play that was 0-for-7 last night is 1-for-1 as the shot from Sergachev is blocked. And another, and they score off the rebound. It's Andre, or check that.
Now this goes back again. Ross Colton gets to the front of the net, working against Merkley. Working it 2-on-1 down low as he's able to slide in. It's the quick shot, ready to shoot attitude that you've talked about, Brett. They get the fortunate bounce, but Colton's there by himself. Logan Couture.
They've only given up 15 this whole game. Ferraro, and there's one that got through, and they're lucky too.
Good battle from Couture, wins the draw, then goes right to the net. That puck comes right through that middle point, and nice tip by Couture, and boy, that puck was off the goalpost, laying there, but good job by Elliott to recover here to make this save. As you can see, it gets through him right there off the goalpost, and Couture
wanted Cirelli. That'll deflect back to Kucherov, and a little too fancy on Couture, and then he took a penalty. So a delay call coming up here on Kucherov. As Foot will slow it down, and that'll put the Sharks on the power play with 12:36 to go.
And Couture didn't fall for the banana in the tailpipe. Right here, gets a little stick and skate on that puck, and there's the hook, gets parallel, draws the penalty.
Barabanov and Hurdle. Meyer's going to have to chase that one back. Just did hold it in. Couture bunts it across, bouncing puck. Elliott trying to find it, and he does, falls back on it. And now Noah Gregor working his way to center. Gregor, nice move, shoots, and Elliott got across. Gregor again behind the net. Bonino tried to backhand it in. Cogliano recovers, Burns a quick shot into traffic, sitting on the goal line. Bonino trying to jam it in, and it does go in by Gregor, but after the whistle.
Yeah, it's Leafs, but watch the blocker of Elliott. Kind of, you know, gets his blocker behind. But as you said, Brad Meyer, referee coming in here. This is actually Brad Meyer's last season as a referee in the National Hockey League. There, that's where Brad lost it. Blow the whistle. And that's, again, that happens in the game.
Here's Tkachuk one more time, and he's just going to burn the rest of the time up on the clock. And this one is over. An impressive night by the defending Stanley Cup champions. They get two goals from one of their fourth line forwards, Ross Colton, and a solid effort in goal from Brian Elliott.